pirate was happy that her treasure was finally found. So she
At this point in the video, the friends learn how stories are put together. Leap helps them recognize how every story has a setting, when and where the story takes place, characters, and a series of events. He explains how these events are sequenced, so every story has a beginning, middle, and end. Research shows that when children can recognize narrative elements and understand how stories are put together, they can more easily focus on the most important story content, comprehend and remember what they've read, and begin to create stories of their own.
Without knowing it!
So every story has characters, a setting that tells where and when the story takes place.
Learning about story structure involves learning the labels for different story elements. Here, Leap prompts the friends to consider what they already know about what goes into a good story. Lily pipes up and says,
"They always take place somewhere and sometime."
Cousin Toad quickly provides an example.
Haunted house.
And Matilda adds,
"Or a long time ago in a faraway land."
After hearing some examples, Leap points out that where and when a story takes place is called the setting.
Stories are always set.
When Leap asks what other elements are in stories, Tad says,
"I once read a story about a super smart inventor.
There was once a story about..."
And Cousin Toad says,
"Ooh, and I remember one about a brave fireman.
I know a story about an amazing artist who..."
Leap tells the friends that these are examples of story characters. Leap asks about other story elements, and Matilda chimes in that there's always something happening in a story. The friends share examples, such as a frog climbing up a giant beanstalk or scoring a winning goal. And Leap is quick to label these as the story events. This explicit labeling of the various narrative elements is designed to help children transfer what they are learning about how stories are put together beyond the examples in the video. The goal is to assist children in recognizing that other stories they encounter contain these same elements.
A summer carnival is a great place to set a story. How about a character card?
I've got a sailor!
And I've got a farmer!
Those are all great characters. Now, who can show me an event card?
One of my favorite aspects of this video is how it models creative storytelling. The friends use their imaginations to build on the story elements shown on the game cards they're dealt. Here, the friends' growing understanding of story elements and story structure helps them create stories of their own. They sing a song designed to reinforce the concept that a story has characters, a setting, and events that create a beginning, middle, and end. The best part is when the friends realize that although some stories can come from books, other really interesting stories can come from their own imaginations. They begin to see themselves as storytellers. At home, you can encourage your own little storyteller by creating your own set of storytelling cards with old photos or pictures from magazines and prompting your child to weave an imaginative tale that includes all the story elements and has a clear beginning, middle, and end. Even without picture cards, you can help build storytelling skills by simply starting a story, turning it over to your child, and taking turns adding events to the tale. Or you can prompt your child to think up a new ending to a familiar story, or retell a favorite story from a different character's point of view. When the story